there is something called reducing the impact of a karma on you. Meditation helps in that. When you meditate on your own self, the impact of even the prarabdha karma become less on you. The more awareness you gather, the greater your skill and strength to cope up with karma more easily. And that is why it looks like karma is there. Other people see the same events happening in your life. They don't impact you the way they would if you were not having an inner awareness. So that's a big advantage. And we call it, it lessens. It lessens your karma. Anything else that lessens your karma? Yes. Darshan of a perfect living master lessens your karma. It gives you an inner. Why does that lessen? Because when we are in the presence of a perfect living master, our soul is pulled by love. And that pull of the love reduces the impact of our karma. It's the impact of the karma that's reduced. If you spend more time, get to know more, it also reduces the impact even more and life becomes tolerable. It does not mean the prarabdha ends, it's there. But it doesn't affect you like it would affect if you didn't have these advantages of reducing their impact. So that is why another good reason, if we are going through bad times, it's a good thing to go have darshan. Or to remember the master also brings up our love and devotion just by remembering a master. So when we have, say, master gives us something, a prasad, for example, blessed food or something, and we eat that food, we remember the master. Impact is reduced of karma. It's not the karma is gone, karma is still there. The impact on you. When you say you, it's a soul. I'm not talking about mind or senses or body. The impact on the soul, which is identifying itself with the mind, senses and body, that impact is reduced. And people who are living their spiritual life, constantly thinking of the master, go through life smoothly. To other people, it looks like, oh, they are looking like just like ordinary lives. But they are not going through ordinary life. They are not going exactly through ordinary life because the impact of these events does not affect them like it affects us ordinary people. So it's a good idea to, when we have an opportunity to meet a perfect living master, good idea to meet as often as we can. I think I mentioned to many of you earlier, and I'll say it again, this question was asked by an American disciple from great master, Baba Savan Singh. He said, Master, how often should we come and see you? He said, the best is to come and see me every day. He said, Master, somebody is not living next to you. How can they come every day? He said, somebody not living near me, then they can come once a week. And I remember when he was saying this, my grandfather was there, I was there, my father was there. We heard this. My grandfather was affected by this statement. And he went every weekend after that to see the master till his death. He went every week because he says that's the minimum one should go and see the master. A wonderful life he led also. He said, but supposing, the American disciple said, supposing one is living very far away. He said, then once a month is good enough. He said, Master, what about us in the United States? We're living very far away. We can't even afford to come once a month. Then what about? He said, once a year is good enough for that. If you come once a year, good enough. He said, Master, supposing we can't come once a year. Then Master smiled. He said, next life is available for that.